So with 10 legendary weapons available within the Outriders demo, I thought I'd bring you guys what in my opinion are the top 5 best. And that's what we have today, people. How's it going, guys? My name's DPJ, and if you enjoyed the video, leaving a like really helps out. And if you like what you see and want to see more Outriders on a daily basis, be sure to subscribe. So within having used all 10 for various hours, I thought I'd bring you guys, and it would be pretty fun, to showcase my top 5 favourite legendaries in the demo. There's 10 in total, but narrowing them down to 5 was pretty easy, so let's start. And in at number 5, people, we have the Voodoo Matchmaker. So the Voodoo Matchmaker is a legendary assault rifle, and well, to be honest, if we were going off designs here, this will probably be in that number 1 spot, because this thing just looks absolutely incredible. And it's one we all questioned within the early trailers, like what the heck is that thing? Well, luckily enough for us, it was one of the 10 legendaries available to try out in the demo. Funny enough, guys, this was actually the last legendary I got out of the 10. 6 days of game time, 6 days of grinding, farming the captains over and over, and it finally dropped. So the Voodoo Matchmaker is an assault rifle with a decent clip size and fire rate, and also having great stability and accuracy. And it feels it when you use it, it feels amazing. And its tier 3 mod is also incredible in taking down groups of adds. The tier 3 mod is called Ultimate Damage Link. Shots link up to 2 enemies sharing 30% of their weapon damage dealt and 10% of their anomaly damage dealt. And it does make for a hard hitting, great assault rifle. So the Voodoo Matchmaker is an incredible weapon. And to be honest, if I didn't main a trickster and wasn't always in the face of the enemy, I'd probably use this way, way more. And that's also if other assault rifles weren't in the demo too. This would probably be my go-to AR. Okay, so let's move on. And in number 4, we have the Rayrog's Gaze. So the Rayrog's Gaze is a legendary rifle, which works like your typical marksman rifle. So like a mixture between an assault rifle and a sniper, but for me, it's the best of both worlds. Now firstly, just look at this thing. It is a thing of beauty. And when I first saw this, which I believe was, I think, my second legendary drop, my jaw dropped. This is how a top tier weapon should look. Now I have used this thing a ton, probably more than I have needed to, just because I like it that much. Now what I will say is, although its tier 3 mod is very useful and one I feel will be truly beneficial in the end game within the full game, I do feel it could have been a little more spectacular. Not in a way in which it works, but a weapon that looks this good you would expect more fireworks, but that just isn't the case. But what it does do is, shots cause explosions, dealing so and so damage and inflicting weakness on enemies within a 5 meter radius of the target with a 3 second cooldown. So Weakness Trap is a tier 3 mod, and like I said, this thing will be super effective in my opinion within the Outriders endgame. Now it's a choice we may have to make and think about, where we either use this weapon or take its mod and apply it elsewhere. But it is seriously interesting to think about that, and what we will be able to do within the full game in terms of customizing other weapons. Okay, so let's move on. And next up, people, in at number 3, we have the Torment and Agony. So the TNAs are dual pistols, which are absolutely stunning to look at. The animation they have and that blue aura look incredible when wielded by that player. But they don't just look pretty. These things truly hit like a truck. Now with a massive magazine size of 40, a high fire rate, when you are playing close and personal, these are hard to match in terms of DPS. But what makes these even more special is that tier 3 mod, Judgment Enforcer. Shots mark enemies. When reloading, you deal 5 times your weapon's damage on every marked enemy. And it is super powerful, people. Now my versions of these, as I've only had one pair drop, were relatively low considering the ones I've seen. But I can confirm, even at this low firepower level, they still hit like a truck, and that reload damage feature is absolutely crazy. And what's even craziest to think about, guys, is that mod. And if we dismantle this weapon, that mod becomes available to use elsewhere. How crazy can this mod make other weapons? That's something you will have to think about. Applying this mod to a high powered sniper could have insane effects, and I cannot wait to experiment. Okay, so moving on, and next up, people, in at number 2 on my list is the Thunderbird. So the Thunderbird, I will admit, is probably here more so for its cosmetic values over how it actually performs. But who cares how powerful a weapon is when it shoots down lightning upon your foes? But on a serious note, this thing looks incredible, sounds incredible, and does incredible things at the same time. So this legendary assault rifle, a lot like the Voodoo Matchmaker with its 40 clip size and 600 rounds per minute rate of fire, along with amazing accuracy and stability, it's very easy to use and it feels great at the same time. My version isn't the highest I've seen, but it still feels extremely powerful. Its tier 3 mod is called Ultimate Storm Whip, where sharks bring down lightning on those enemies. And although I haven't mentioned them much within this video, I do feel this weapon's second mod, Strike, I believe that's pronounced, is worth mentioning. 30% of critical damage dealt is returned to you as health. This is very useful, and on a weapon that is easy to use like this, it's super effective. And within the hands of classes like the Pyromancer, who I believe only get their health back via burning enemies, and once in the full game when we get access to those full skill trees, with the Pyro's Assault Master perk, this could be quite a weapon to use on said class. Or on the other hand, this could be a very useful mod for other weapons, which you may want to upgrade to use on the Pyromancer. But yeah guys, the Thunderbird is an amazing weapon, and to me it represents exactly what top tier weapons should be, in terms of what it does, how it looks, and how it presents itself. They don't get much better than this. Okay, so moving on, and lastly, my number one favourite weapon from the demo isn't one that looks amazing. It doesn't have any flashy colours sparkling away. It just does what needs to be done and does it incredibly. The weapon in which I feel is the best in the demo is the Airy Master. So the Airy Master is a legendary pump action shotgun. It only has 3 in its mag, poor recoil, poor stability, but that doesn't matter people, because within those 3 shots, it has incredible DPS values. This thing hits hard, very hard guys. So because I main a trickster, obviously being in the enemy's face is the way forward. And this weapon just adds so much to that style of play to make it way, way more efficient. Its tier 3 mod is called Weightlessness. Shots inflict time rift on enemies, which basically immobilizes enemies for 5 seconds. This is actually an ability on a trickster, which we'll get access to in the full game. But this tier 3 mod just makes using the trickster just so much more effective. And I feel when the full game actually drops, for the trickster and devastator classes who both have perks on their skill trees, which buff shotguns and close range damage, this Airy Master could be one of the better weapons in the game to chase. But either way guys, I cannot wait to find out. But yes, the Airy Master in my opinion is the best weapon in this demo. So guys, the full game releases on April 1st, and until then we are limited to only 10 legendaries. But hey, tell me your top 5 down below. But on that note, the end of the video has arrived. These have been my top 5 legendaries from the Outriders demo. If you enjoyed the video, leaving a like really helps out. If you're new around here and want to see more Outriders on a daily basis, be sure to subscribe. And hopefully people, I will see you on that next one.